So in the sports industry, you just talked about one, your foundation, two, your business pursuit in terms of your sportswear line. Now, we have a lot of administrators. You just advised athletes a while ago. We have administrators, sports fans, and in governments out there. Potentially, some people might listen to this program today or maybe in the future, because this podcast will be available from now till forever. What would you say to these folks out there who do not seem to understand the value of sports as an industry?
No, I'm telling you, because to be conscious about something, you have to really get a bigger vision.
Yes.
You don't have to look at your little belly. You don't have to look at your little $100,000, your $200,000, your $1 million. You have to think about something bigger. You have to have a vision, you know. And what's missing in the black community or the African community is big vision, big things. It's like somebody have $100,000, they want to, or a certain amount of money, they want to eat it right away. They could buy the last car, that last car that cost $80,000, and start bluffing at each other instead of creating something so that you can employ others and build, create a business to build a community. That's lacking in our community is vision, is greatness, is to see, is to have like long-term future, you know. And we are still looking up to other people to do things for us instead of building our own confidence, building our own business, you know. And people always need to go and take without really confidence in our own potential, you know. And still, in certain African minds, I'm not the champion. Europeans help me to be champion, and I'm telling them that I am the champion because I wake up every morning, 6 o'clock, 8 o'clock. I was in the track, and I made myself a champion. I used the opportunity to become a champion because you have to know how to seize the opportunity. And we don't know how to seize opportunity to become the best. Because when we are just only thinking about, it's really difficult to understand how we our mind process, you know, especially the certain leaders, the process of our mind is just not going anywhere. You
Gotcha.
know, people have money and try to look at others down and trying to be, you know, get a boy to do things for you. They don't want to do anything for themselves, you know. So, I mean, it's simple. We just need to get people to get better vision. Get a long-term process, see visualizing the community themselves in a better way. Look at certain places. Lots of people have gone to different places, but they never learn. I don't know how or why.
That's
You know,
a
I don't know.
yeah.
I'm always asking people that come to Europe, I say, what have you learned from Europe apart from showing off pictures to your families back home, showing them cars, maybe it's not yours? Before, in front of taking pictures in front of nice buildings, what have you learned? You know, I don't know, something is deeply wrong. Don't you want to build your community, get together? Europeans are always on time. You always, oh, we black people. Is that our culture to be late? You know, that's a little thing, first of all. Is that our culture not to respect one another? You know, there are little things you have to put in place because sometimes you have to think about vision, and then you have lots of big vision, and you don't even have the least respect for the people you're working with. You know, so it's just different things that came to my mind. I'm trying to piece things out
I know, I
together,
know,
but
I know. It's huge. It's huge. This is big stuff.
it's
And
huge, you know. But it's simple, you know, because we can just we can do lots of things, but we just have to think about it. We just have to think about being better with others than being better and looking down on others. Because when we have certain opportunity, we look down on others. In Europe, black people, when they have certain opportunities, they look down on other black people, so I think that the other black people are lazy, mm-hmm. they don't want to work. Instead of giving them transferring their knowledge.
Right.
We don't transfer our knowledge anymore. Our ancestors used to do that. When somebody have something, they'll look at, oh, no, you know, I work. We were woke. Now, these are the privilege. I don't want to see you anymore. And they even run away. They even run away from their community. And we're not going to do anything better with that type of mentality. We just have to focus. We just have to have bigger vision, respect, little things, and piece up little things. And then, see what... I see certain things Africans are doing. We copy from A to Z, American or Europeans. NBA. I know it's national. That's what is NBA in Africa? That's an American basketball thing.
Yes.
Why can't we create ours and make our big money?
Yes.
Because I don't really understand.
Yeah,
I don't know what's happened. That's the business you're talking that we cannot even control.
That's right.
Instead, we copy the same name and transfer it to Africa. Africa is how many countries? 59, 55, I don't know.
55.
What's wrong? Uh-huh. Something's really wrong.
Yes.
Why should they copy exactly? I don't know. I don't say don't inspire.
Mm-hmm.
But why should we take the exact name. To give it to your own... continent. It's not even a national thing.
Gotcha. That's a very good point. It's all about mentality, you know. Yes, you're right.
It's just a set of our mentality.
Yeah.
Why is it that you have to go and take other coaches instead of taking your own former athletes?
Yes.
And these coaches can give you better scouting and do exchange with your athletes and get money.
Absolutely.
Instead, all the especially in football, especially in soccer.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You're right.
It's really big economic, but we have to know how to manage the money, get better environment, so we can get more money. You know, but we don't know how to use money to get more money. We know how to consume and spend and lavish. That's what we know about. We don't know that money is used to make more money.
Yes, we have a consumer culture in there. So,
you know? So people have to be aware, with the internet today, we don't have any excuse.
You're right.
Internet, because when people going, Africans going to Oxford, African going to Harvard, they were miseducated for the masses. Because when they go there, they think they're educated. They don't even educate them about, because how can you go to those schools and never learn how to build your community?
You're right, and they will put so much premium on them. Oh, he's in Oxford. Oh, that person went to Cambridge. Yeah.
World champion.
Yeah.
When somebody helps me, supports me, I become the world champion.
Yes.
So I don't know how they're still educating Africans, and we're still lacking as much as we have today.
You got a good point. You got an awesome point there.
People that can help you and be better. When somebody helps you, you have to be better.
Yes.
Helping somebody today, I want them to become better than me.
Absolutely.
So I don't know. So certain thing, we just need, that's a very long process, but we're getting there because we now have some independent radio like you, programs, magazines and everything. Mm-hmm. So people need to get their head, not only in schools, but be a self-maker, you know.
Right.
Learn for themselves. Go get information, not be too close-minded, a little bit open-minded. Go and see what's happening in the agriculture industry, the sports industry, the cinema industry. I'm just so amazed about the certain things we do in Europe and in Africa and still call that cinema. You know, it's all about cheating. There's no scientific thing about films and everything. So there is something missing.
Yeah.
You know, so we have, and that's big industry, and we have to learn to control what we're doing, not only putting people behind you or in front of you to control you and your community.
Gotcha. You know? Wow, awesome interview, awesome conversation we've had this morning. Final word, what's your word of advice to young girls coming up in Africa?
My advice for young girls is, first of all, respect yourself, self-respect. You know, you have to learn about who you are, what you want to be, where you want to go, and yeah, who you want to be with, because that's really important. Some people are energy sucker. You know, I'm very protective of myself. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm always, you know, you have to take care of your body, take care of your mind, you know. Mm-hmm. I used to do yoga. I'm still doing sports, even though my back is aching me so much after a long career.
Okay.
But, you know, you have to get certain way where you can get peaceful. If you have peace of your mind, you can really have peace with other people.
Yes.
You know, you don't have to really go into this type of mentality. Oh, women are the girls, they have big mouth, they're this, we are only, you know, I'm big, but, you know, these things are just things that are not really helping. So we have to really find self-respect and find ourselves.
Gotcha.
The more simple you are, the better you are.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Thank you so much, Eunice, and appreciate you coming on, and definitely there's a conversation that we'll continue to have. You're a great resource and you're a great inspiration to many out there.
I'm still waiting. Sorry about that. Continue. I'm still waiting if maybe there's Sierra Leone authorities have to recognize the potential of their former athletes or people who have been there to mentor, call them to mentor also the community.
Yes.
You know, not only, and I really want to do that for my community. For
right.
The benefit of people, you know.
Gotcha. That's awesome. Once again, thank you very much, and I appreciate you coming on.
Okay. You're welcome. Have a good one.
You too.
Okay, bye-bye.
You're the one I want though. Before my liver start to fail, you're the one I need though. Before cassava.
Before we go any further, I want to let you know that this program is being brought to you by African Sports Monthly Magazine. Africa's number one and only comprehensive sports magazine that covers all sports disciplines across the continent and beyond. Subscribe today and qualify to be entered into a draw for 2 free tickets brought to you by our proud partner and sponsor, Ethiopian Airlines, to the Africa Cup of Nations in Cameroon from June 7th to the 30th in 2019.
My baby lifetime insurance, yeah. Assurance, oh no. Assurance, yeah. I give my baby assurance. I give my baby lifetime insurance.
1996 Atlanta Olympics, 1994 Nation Cups in Tunisia, and the 1994 World Cup were products of private funding. These athletes did Nigeria proud. We can do it again. Do you know that with 200 Naira only, you can change the face of Nigerian participation at the Olympics? Only 4.5 million Nigerians with 200 Naira contribution will change the fortune of our athletes. The contribution commences from the 1st of September to the 30th of November 2018. 90 whole days. Only 200 Naira. 4.5 million Nigerians. With you, it is possible. Our name. We want to give 90 athletes from 5 sports 10 million Naira athletes development grant each. Pay your 200 Naira contribution to Access Bank Nigeria. Account number 00154647 07. Under the name NSDFI. For further inquiries, log on to www.nsdfi.com. Get to the Elite Athlete Development Grant. Follow the prompt. Help make Nigerian sports greater, stronger, and better. Together, we can actualize our sport dreams. We can and we will. This message is courtesy of Nigerian Sport Development Fund Incorporated, Abuja.
My baby assurance, I give my baby lifetime insurance.